In this video, we'll show you how to add Wi-Fi to the Garmin Tread Base Edition. Before we get going, just explain a couple of symbols. This means GPS signal strength, and this, of course, is your Bluetooth. We're already paired via our smartphone via the Bluetooth. That's why the symbol is blue. But to add Wi-Fi, all we need to do is tap on the gear icon. And the first time that you're doing this, you'll be presented with a setup wizard where you add Wi-Fi, pair a Bluetooth headset, and connect to your smartphone. But you can do this at any time. So basically, once we get into our settings, we'll see wireless networks. And from here, we can see that we're connected to our smartphone, Bluetooth is enabled. But also down here, we have our Wi-Fi section. So what we're going to do here, we're going to search for some Wi-Fi. And here's our Wi-Fi. I'm going to enter the password. All right, so now we're connected to our Wi-Fi network. And with this, we're now able to do a basic setting, which is to check for any updates. So now that it's checked for the update, we can see we have a map update and a software update. If you do to install all, it will take us 3.5 hours just because the map update is so big. But we're going to do the software update. And we can verify our version update. We can see the size of this update. And we can see some of the issues that it's going to fix. So what we're going to do here is we're going to install all. But before we do that, we're going to check the previous version to verify that it's going to install itself properly. So in order to do that, we're just going to go down to Device and About. And we can see here we're on 6.8 on our firmware, and we're going to update. So we're going to tap on that. And now we're back to our updates. We can also update this via USB to our computer using Garmin Express, but we can do this via Wi-Fi. So we're going to choose again our software, install all. And we're going to follow the instructions, and we're going to hit start. All right, it's recommended that we connect the Tread to a power source via USB, at least 1 amp output, so that we can do it, because it takes so long to install. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to hit OK, and I'm going to just plug this in. I'm currently on a 2.4 amp output. There we go. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to hit start. And we'll let it go and see what happens. All right, the update is finished installing, and now the system is going to reboot. So we have our standard load screen. We'll start to see the copyright and the maps information here at the bottom. And now we're going to select a locale. Choose our language. And we'll accept the user agreement. And there you go. We are now updated to 6.9. And what kind of defaults we want to use for navigation? We're going to choose this one. And I think we can do this. And of course, we can always change this in the settings menu. We'll tap on next. And now we're finally back out. And now we can verify in our device settings. There you go, 6.9. And now, as I said, I can either tap on this, start downloading the maps wirelessly, or I can just plug into my computer in Garmin Express and do it via the computer that way, which I think is a more recommended way to do it. You can see here now with just with the map updates, 6 hours, how big? I think we have quite a few. 3.4 gigs, 5.5, 6.6. So City Navigator, North America. Topo Active Power Sports, US parcel data, and iOverlander worldwide POIs. That's going to take a while to download, so I definitely will recommend do that via Garmin Express. But anyway, that is how you add Wi-Fi to your Garmin Tread so that you can update the software.